Okay, here's another problem. Solve the system by graphing. And we have two equations, x minus y is 4 and x equals y minus 1. So we need to graph each line. So let's do the first line, x minus y equals 4. If you want, get out a piece of graph paper and do it and then come back to see if you get the same line I do. All right, I'm going to do it by x and y intercepts. The x intercept is 4, 0 and the y intercept is negative 4. So, let's see, carefully graph that line. The hard part about solving a system by graphing is you have to be extremely accurate. Otherwise, it might look like your two lines are crossing at the wrong point. So you have to be very, very careful and accurate. All right, the next one, y equals x minus 1. Oh, there's the phone. Okay, so the second line, I'm going to use slope-intercept method, y equals x minus 1, and I'm going to do this in green, so the y-intercept's negative 1, and the slope is 1, because that's the coefficient of x. So we go over 1 and up 1, over 1 and up 1, over 1 and up 1, and what's going on here? Both of these lines have a slope of 1. So this line, y equals x minus 1, and the other line, x minus y equals 4, are parallel lines. They're never going to meet. So this is an inconsistent solution, which means there's no solution. That is the answer to the problem. No solution. Not NS. No solution. Okay. Let's try a different one. Okay. Here's another problem. Solve the system by graphing. We have two equations, x equals 1 and y equals 2x minus 3. Now remember, we're solving a system of linear equations. So this first equation, x equals 1, is a line. It is not a point right here at x equals 1. There are a lot of other points on that line. In fact, everywhere where you have an ordered pair where the x value is 1. This is the vertical line. So that's the graph of x equals 1. It's so easy that people often just put one point, the point 1, 0. But it's a line. All right, now let's do the purple one. Y equals 2x minus 3. So I'm going to do slope-intercept method. We've got the y-intercept is down at 0, negative 3. And I'm going to go over 1 and up 2, over 1 and up 2, over 1 and up 2, and we graph this line. So that's the line y equals 2x minus 3. And let's see, where do they intersect? Looks like it's right there at 1, negative 1. So let's check it. We're going to check 1, negative 1 into x equals 1. Well, if we're going to put in 1 for x, yep, that works. Now let's check 1, negative 1 into y equals 2x minus 3. So we're putting in negative 1 for y, 1 for x. That gives you negative 1 equals 2 minus 3, also negative 1. Good. So that means our ordered pair, it looks like our ordered pair over here is correct. 1, negative 1 is the solution. All right, let's try one more. Okay, here's another one. Solve the system by graphing. All right, I want you to do this. Get out your own graph paper. Graph the line x minus y equals 2. Then graph the line y equals x minus 2. And then determine the solution. Okay. Put it on pause and do that. Hope you're back. I'm ready to go. So, how am I going to do x minus y equals 2? I'm going to use x and y intercepts. The x intercept is at 2, 0, because if you put in 0 for y, you get x equals 2. And the y intercept, well, if you put in 0 for x, you would get negative y equals 2, so y is negative 2. So the first equation goes to these two points, and of course you have to graph very carefully. That is the equation x minus y equals 2. All right, now we're going to graph the purple one. Y equals x minus 2. I'm going to use the slope-intercept method. going to start down at the y-intercept at negative 2, and then I have a slope of 1, right? So I'm going over up 1, over 1 and f1, and what happens is, it's this exact same line. So that's also the line y equals x minus 2. Well, so they intersect everywhere. So this is called a dependent solution, a dependent system. And we say the answer is there are infinitely many ordered pairs. Infinitely many solutions or ordered pairs. In fact, it's not any old ordered pairs, right? It's really all the ones on this line. Now, if I would have taken each of these equations and put in slope-intercept form, notice if I would have subtracted x from both sides, I would get negative y equals negative x plus 2. And then if I change the signs on both sides, which is multiplying both sides by negative 1 or dividing both sides by negative 1, I get x minus 2. You would notice that is the same as this other line to begin with. So you can verify it really is the same equation. All right, so we graphed a few of these, and what's important is that you're extremely accurate. If they are intersecting at some fraction, it is really hard to tell. And so it's especially important that you always check your ordered pair solution in each of the original equations before you solve for y or did anything else. And that's it for solving systems by graphing.